This year's event is called Circus DQ, and the theme is carnival theme. At this relay, people are encouraged to walk laps, buy things from local vendors,
stuff for keeping busy this summer, and this is a fall.
And buy raffle tickets in the hopes of winning prizes. Yeah,
things to decorate with for fall.
Teresa Kerr has been a part of Relay for Life since 2003. She also set up a Relay for Life museum that has a bunch of photos and articles of people who are a part of the relay.
Well, I started relaying for a friend, but since then, my mother, my father, and my brother, older brother, have all been diagnosed with cancer. My father has passed away 2 years ago, but my brother and mother are both surviving.
In just a few moments, bags like these, called luminarias, which have a candle inside them, will be turned on and lit for everyone all across Central Park to see. Now with these bags, you can decorate them with whatever message, a photo, or sticker to commemorate someone who has either survived or has lost their battle to cancer. This bag is Leslie's and Ed's. Leslie is an event supervisor here, and she's been working for Relay for Life for many years.
I relay for the memory of all of the women in my family that have passed. We joined Relay for Life the day after my sister passed because we wanted to do something for her and something to honor her life and her struggle. And we've been doing it for the last 10 years.
The feeling of losing a loved one, the burden that many people may feel, and the grief that no one ever gets past due to this deadly disease can be felt throughout this last lap. But there is one thing that people should always keep in mind. When going through this battle, the feeling of hope and the feeling that I will defeat cancer. For KNews, I'm Drew Little Sorrell.